What's the deal with the month of Muharram and this day called Ashura? Do we fast it? And why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us something very interesting in Surah Al-Tawbah. He says, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ شُورِهِ عِنَّ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوَا خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ ذَلَكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that there are 12 months according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the day that He created the heavens and the earth, and four of them are sacred, special. That is the upright and the blessed religion, and do not wrong yourselves therein. And so what do we know? We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did indeed give us yani time, did indeed divide it into months. Of them are 12, four of them are special, and from these four, one of the great months is Muharram. It is the first month of the new year, the Hijri year, something that we're in now, and we're very, very close to one very special day in it called Ashura. Ashura comes from Al-Ashra, which is the 10th. The 10th of Ashura, the 10th of Muharram, which is called Ashura, was the day which the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam entered upon Medina, and he saw the Jews of Medina happy, and they're fasting and celebrating. And happiness was always shown as some kind of gratitude, and fasting was being always an expression of gratitude, as Allah told us in the Quran that the people before us used to fast as well, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. And it's now done for ourselves too, that we can become more disciplined, the people of taqwa. That's what Ramadan is for. But so when people would be seen fasting, it's a sign of something great. And when he asked them what's going on, they said, well, this is the day that Allah saved the tribe of Israel, the children of Israel, and Musa alayhi salam, and he led them to safety. This is why we're celebrating it. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is like, well, hold on, we have a greater right to Musa alayhi salam than any other nation, especially you guys. And so he then sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started to fast it and told his companions to do so as well. Not just that, but he wanted to stamp a little bit of an extra USP on it, a bit of a brand on it. And so he wanted to be different. And so he said, if I'm around next year, then I'm going to fast the day before it as well. The 9th was called Tasu'a. And in fact, there's another hadith as well, which also indicates that the day after the 10th, the 11th, should be fasted too. Although the hadith has a slight a little bit of weakness. In any case, the scholars then really encouraged the fasting of this month, and then especially the 10th, or the 9th and the 10th. You might say, why? Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, said that, I never saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fast in any month as he did in Muharram, except Ramadan. That was the only month that he completely fasted. But next to it was Muharram. And the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that afdalus siyam ba'da Ramadan shahrullah al-Muharram, that the best of fasting after the fast of Ramadan is the month of Allah al-Muharram. So the sacred month of Allah, it's like, even the name, even the title, is like it's Allah's personal month, right? Al-Muharram, the sacred month. Even the word itself, in the name itself, has haram in it, right? The root word haram is to be taken from it. So it is sacred intrinsically. So if we recognize that, and then know that to fast the 10th as well. And by the way, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said about the 10th, about Ashura, the day of Ashura, and أَحْنَسِبُ عَلَى اللَّهِ, that I consider and I make it upon Allah, and I expect it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that and you kafir as-sana alati qablahu, that He subhanahu wa ta'ala will expiate the sins of the previous year that have occurred from us, that just fasting this one day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will expiate the sins, the minor sins, which is no small matter. And that's why Allah in Surah At-Tawbah said, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ, don't wrong yourselves therein. Meaning, I've given you this special gift, an extra mercy for you, whether you realize it or not, but don't waste it, don't wrong yourself. Grab the opportunity and fast. And what's the best way of fasting it? The 10th by itself is allowed, but the sunnah is to add that 9th to it, and it's allowed even to add the 11th to it. So you could say, if in order of preference, that the best would be to fast the 9th and the 10th, and if not, then the 10th and the 11th, and if not, then the 10th by itself. And if someone fasted all 3 days because they're not too sure about when the month starts, and because we do have that kind of fitna, are we following Saudi, are we following local Saudi sightings, blah blah blah, then I think it's acceptable in that time of fitna to be able to fast 9, 10 and 11 to cover all possibilities. So that's the month of Allah al-Muharram. Respect yourself by not oppressing yourself and wronging yourself, as Allah says. Take the opportunity to fast this day. Add the 9th before it. It's a great sunnah. We have a great right upon Musa alayhi salam. We are the ones who should be establishing these acts of gratitude through fasting. So make sure that you respect the month of Allah, Al-Muharram, and the day, Al-Ashura.